The MCI drill is a mass casualty incident that was put on by a bunch of clubs here at campus. These are student-run organizations, along with some local EMS organizations and our lovely ICC staff.
Today we're simulating a collapse of the bleachers, and we're having EMS respond to that collapse. And then they're going to be transporting some mannequin patients, as well as some moulaged up students, to what we call our first-year students to be triaged. And then our second year students will be located in the ICC emergency room and actively treating the patients that are brought to them.
Essentially what we wanted to do was we wanted to give students the opportunity to practice medicine and to get some experience working with patient populations in high stress environments such as those involved in natural disasters, incidents involving multiple patients at the same time, to give them a little bit of stress, give them a little bit of chaos, see how they react, and give them that opportunity to handle this in a more low impact environment prior to going out into the real world and doing this with real patients.
I think it's important because it's very rare to get a good MCI or any sort of MCI drill, and to have one of this scale has been very unique. I've been a part of different MCI drills in the past that just involved the primary triage and the first responder unit, but this is the first ever MCI drill that contained the second portion of the hospital unit, which has been really, really cool, and I got to be a part of the hospital unit, which is the first time I've ever done that, so that was a really cool experience.
So the events like this are important for everybody, because for us in EMS, we kind of stop at that emergency room door. So we don't always get to see the fun interventions that happen once you're in the emergency room with a trauma team and all that stuff. We kind of run in, drop the patient off, and run out, because we got to go to the next emergency. So it's nice to be able to sit and kind of watch a little bit and see, you know, what happens and how they go about it.
So the biggest takeaway I think I would say I want the students to get from all of this is to get a little bit more comfortable with the chaos. Everything's not always going to go well, but when you start to communicate within your team, you start to fall back on the training that you've received thus far, and then you look to those with more training in these situations, generally they'll end up pretty favorably. And even when they don't end up perfectly favorably, stepping back and doing a good debrief, kind of processing everything that happened, so you're walking away in a healthy manner rather than with regret or certain aspects of like self-consciousness.
So my main objective today is to have them understand the importance of communication, the communication from one level of student to the second level of student, and then the actual treatment of the patient. Are we treating the patients to the level that they're capable of treating right now?
So this shows what the comm has to offer, right? I don't think that you will see very many other medical schools on the East Coast, let alone in the United States, that have the resources to throw at a drill like this. I mean, we have 8 high fidelity mannequins that we will be utilizing for the training of our medical students and local residents tonight, as well as 20 some odd student actors, 40 to 50 participants acting as providers in some sense, but it's also a great opportunity for the comm to show what it truly has to offer and demonstrate why we are one of the best osteopathic medical schools, period, in the nation.